originated from Martin Buckley.
Yeah. Right.
He was short milk or something one morning, and
there was nowhere in Pullough to get anything, yeah.
And had to go to Ballycumber for it. So he came upon the idea of just opening up the community shop just for the essentials, the bread and milk and the usual bits, and it kind of lifted off from there.
So there's about eight to ten people from time to time. So we take in one or two and we lose one or two. But there's always good stories. So the one or two that we've lost lately have gone on to get jobs. So they've used the experience that they've had here volunteering, and to put on their CV, and they have the experience now, and they're able to go and get jobs out of it. So it's a good story. And then there's always one or two that are looking to get involved. And I always say to come in here for an hour or two just to give a dig out. It's great. Like, I still do 2 hours on a Friday evening. Like, the shop has, I suppose, became the hub, and I suppose it has expanded from that as well. So I suppose we are located here in Pullough. A lot of people have come into the village in the last couple of years. We have bikes put in place, and we're right on the Greenway. So we're only maybe a half an hour cycle to Loughborough, and a half an hour cycle back into Tullamore. So we're right in the central of, I suppose, the Midlands. We're right in the know, and people come out here for the quietness and, of course, the friendliness of people in the local area. And we all have a chat out here, and if people come, they can have tea and coffee and have a chat with the volunteers. So it's great, it's great.
Yeah, and we do have a great community.
There is definitely, because I'm not from Pullough, I'm from Fabban.
Oh,
and there is,
so am I.
Well, I blew in there as well. So. But there is most definitely a good community spirit in Pullough. I found that with people coming in and out here, people are lovely. Yeah.
It's a brilliant way of making friends, because I didn't really know that many people when I came here. So to be behind the counter and you have so many different people coming in, and everybody has a different story. It's brilliant.
Mm. Yeah.
I took a wrong turn one day and never got out of the place. Just like that.
So did you marry into
it? I did, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
And how did you get involved in this place?
Well, as I said, I've been here about 10 or 12 years. And in 2015, we lost one of our twin daughters. And the community around here were absolutely brilliant. Never witnessed anything like it. And being from Dublin, things like that come and go, you know, you wouldn't even see. But for weeks here, the whole place changed, and they were brilliant. So I have disabilities, so I decided to try to get involved in a few different things. The shop was one of them, so I'm here since day one with the shop.
Right. So sorry to hear about
that. Yeah, no problem at all.
Yeah.
They don't name me sometimes, but of course I'm well able for it, and I have to take back what they give me as well, because I can't be too, you know yourself, Anne-Marie, you can't be too. You have to give and take in this game.
Would you be a rogue now? Would you be seen as a rogue?
I would be a rogue. I would. I wouldn't have a great name. They'd be always slagging me about something and that. I'm a widow man now, on my own. You see, 22 years. This place means everything to me, Anne-Marie, because I'm living on my own, and when the evening comes, in the winter time in particular, I'm in from 4:30 till I get up around 7 or 8 o'clock in the morning, and the first thing when the shop opens, I come over here. And I'm always meeting someone. The staff is great here, and they're all. And if I'm not out, they're worried about me. They're ringing me, or they'll come in to see if I'm okay. But only for the shop now, I'd be very badly hit, very, very badly hit.
I saw a post on Facebook about looking for volunteers, and I wasn't working at the time. And we were in the middle of the pandemic, so I decided to volunteer.
What are the customers like? How do you like it?
Yeah, they're friendly, and especially Sunday morning, people collect their newspapers, so you get to know names and faces. So it's definitely helped me get to know more people in the community.
I suppose this was the attraction to the kids. It was the selection of sweets that we had, chocolates and tejos. So they were the...
Now admit it, Martin.
Yeah.
Do you eat the old sweets?
Oh, I do, without a doubt. Without a doubt, I'd have a sweet tooth as well. There's no doubt about it.
Yeah.
They're just a great bunch of people. And anybody that comes even to stay during the summer and will always come back. Because they always say, Pullough is a lovely place. And of course, I met my lovely wife here, so I'm stuck here now. But no, I love the area. I'd never move back to Dublin, to be honest with you.